In this video, I'll explain why you might want to add subtitles to your IGTV videos, where it might be best to put them, and how to do it. Why have subtitles at all? First of all, accessibility. You're making your video accessible to the deaf and hard of hearing. Number two, the viewer may be watching in an environment where they can't turn on their phone's speaker, and they don't have headphones handy. And number three, you want to grab the viewer even if they haven't turned on audio yet. This is more true when you're trying to stop thumbs from scrolling past, so we'll see how effective it is for IGTV over time. What about where to place your subtitles? I would suggest placing them outside of where the IGTV overlay is shown. Why would you want to do this if these overlays are hidden most of the time? It isn't that the overlay obscures your subtitles when someone wants to bring up an overlay. After all, they probably don't need to read your subtitles at that moment. But your subtitles, if positioned under the overlay, can make the overlay harder to read. So where exactly does this overlay get placed? Based on my measurements, the top of the overlay text, including your comment count, is 345 pixels from the bottom of the 1920 pixel height image. Now let's talk about how to add subtitles. This is a five-step process. Step one, upload your video to a site like YouTube that will automatically generate closed captions. Number two, download the SRT file that YouTube produced. Number three, convert the SRT file to an FCP XML file. This can be done with tools like resolver.tools, which uses subsimple to create the FCP XML file from your SRT file. Step four, import the FCP XML file into your nonlinear editor of choice that supports FCP XML. For the free editor, DaVinci Resolve, download link in the description, there are three substeps. Number one substep, figure out what track you want your subtitles to go on. Number two substep, in an empty file, create that track, import the FCP XML file, select all, and copy to clipboard. Substep number three, open your video and paste from the clipboard. Finally, no matter what nonlinear editor you're using, the last step is to adjust the size and position of your text and republish your video with burned-in captions. With Resolve, you position your text by selecting it and bringing up the inspector. I like to use white text against a dark background, so I create a track for the background and place a solid color generator from the toolbox in the effects library. I make the background 134 pixels high, which is 7% of 1920. I position it so that the bottom is just above the top of the overlay text. If you found I went through the steps a little fast, click the link in the description to visit the article I wrote so that you can go step by step at your own pace.